Hey everyone, I just wanted to hop on and share a little bit of a new workflow I'm trying to develop using Midjourney and specifically version 4. So these are some pavilion designs that we've been working on in Midjourney that will become a real thing. We're looking to 3D print a pavilion with my local municipality. So we're working on utilizing these advanced technologies. The pavilion is supposed to represent the idea of advanced technologies in collaboration with sustainability efforts. And so we're looking to 3D print mud or adobe. And so some of these forms are, supposed to facilitate the ease of 3D printing with arches, although we understand that they're actually presenting some difficulties in that, so it's a bit of a research project as well. But these are just some of the iterations that we have been flipping through, being inspired by some of the different textures, arches, panelization that we've seen. And we've taken those images and we've started to develop some 3D models that are loosely based on the images that are being produced. And so this is something that we are looking to 3D print here shortly at a small scale, just to start to understand how these parts and pieces are going to come together. I also wanted to share, this is sort of a bit of a theoretical approach on this new workflow that we're imagining. The traditional workflow we see as conceptualizing, engineering the form, documenting the form, and constructing, but we are trying to push this new emergent type of workflow, which is more of a generate and then componentizing the model for 3D printing or other different forms of digital fabrication typologies. So once we've taken these images of our sort of reinterpreted form, we have put them back into Midjourney using version 4, and it's creating some pretty impressive drawings. And we know it's not quite there yet, but here's another example of some iterations, generations that once we put our model back into version 4 and instructed it to provide construction drawings for us, it produced some pretty interesting drawings, as you can see here. So I wanted to show that process of version 4, at least in this last kind of step of the workflow. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload an image to work from, and I've got my folder here where previously we used an image that was colorized, but I've gone ahead and desaturated it, and I want to see what it's going to produce using this image. So click the plus sign, I selected my image, and then you have to click enter for it to actually process and upload. After that, you select the image, open the original, and take the HTML site and copy it, and we will use that to plug back into Midjourney to prompt version 4 to create our architectural drawings. So I'm going to start by typing / imagine, pasting in our image reference, and then just for ease to show you guys, I want to just copy and paste what I did before because it was producing some pretty good drawings off that. So I'm going to paste that in there, conclude with --v(4). And hit enter. And while that loads, I'll show you our 3D print model. So what we do to prepare it for 3D print, these are all individual components, and so we're going to start by 3D printing just one. So I'll move this back into place. I'm just going to select it, and if I have it selected, there is a plugin for SketchUp. If you go to File, export STL. I believe that's what the plugin is called. I'll find a link to it and provide it in the description. If I select export STL, it asks if I want to export only the current selection, and in this case I do want to. My units are feet, yes, file format A, S, C, II, that's okay. So I want to export it. I'll save it into my folder here. I'm just going to resave over this version, SynthArc 001. And when I go to open it, at least on Windows 10, you have a 3D builder where you can actually view this. This model is not to scale, and it's not prepared to print quite yet, but I just wanted to show you quickly what the process would be like. The reason this program is also good, we like opening it up in here. It's a quick way to make sure that the model is sealed shut if there were any gaps in it due to the geometry. So it always prompts you at the bottom right hand corner here to repair the model, and so it does that quickly. And then if you file save it, it'll save the model with the repaired geometry, and it'll be prepared and ready to print. So this is just one module that we're looking to 3D print, and we're looking at a couple different methods of achieving the arch. One technique is to actually flip the structure upside down and print so that gravity is, we're using gravity to our advantage. So anyway, that's a quick little background on that. And so I wanted to kind of reveal where we're at here with these drawings. So this is the image I put in, and with version 4, unfortunately, they can only do square images right now. But these are the architectural drawings that it is producing when we prompt it to produce, construction drawings, architectural drawings, and I think they're like amazing. They're fabulous. They look amazing. They don't have a lot of maybe applicable details yet. This one in the top left-hand corner, it does look like it's starting to add some details and some dimensions, some notations. But we're really curious with this back and forward process of taking these images, reflecting it in our model, taking snapshots of the model. Here, while I'm speaking, I'll just upscale or do a couple versions on 1 and 3 here. And let's just upscale number 1. But the flow going from basically what you saw here are inspiration images, doing a double vaulted 3D printed Adobe mud architectural pavilion, building our 3D model, taking images of the 3D model and putting them back into Midjourney to be either re-inspired or to work on some details. That's a new workflow, the Emergent workflow, that we're looking to make progress on. So anyway, that's just a quick little update on where we're at with that. Here's sort of the high resolution image that it produced based off that. Very cool. Just wanted to share it with you guys, and I will share more progress after we get a couple of these 3D print modules printed and assembled to see how it affects our process and how we want to maybe go for a redesign. Definitely an interesting workflow. Hopefully we can start to see it a little more in real world practice or academia. I think it's going to start there first, but that's why we're pursuing a project that's not client funded, and it's simply funded with the village. And thanks for watching. If you've got any questions about this process, or if you guys are exploring this process as well, I'd be very curious to see what type of progress you guys are making and how you're using it to either inform your design process or have it reflect the design process or be inspired by images that are produced or reproduced. So keep in touch, put your comments below, and let's keep making progress together. Thanks. Bye.